When it comes to chickpeas, you probably think savory, but Rebecca Coleman, author of the new book Aqua Fabulous, is here to show us a sweeter side. Good morning, Rebecca. Thanks for being here.
It helps when you do jazz hands.
I know. It makes it a little more exciting, doesn't it?
It totally does.
Aqua Fabulous. And the word there is aquafab.
Yeah.
Now, I had never heard of this before. This is kind of a new thing.
And you're not alone. It's a really new thing. So basically what aquafaba is, it is Latin for bean water. And what it is it's the water that you drain out of a can of beans or a can of chickpeas. I primarily use chickpeas. You can really use any kind of white beans. I also use tofu water. And basically what you do is most people drain out this water and they throw it down the drain.
That's what, right? We rinse the peas and...
And this stuff is actually an amazing egg white substitute. So if you take this and you put it into a stand mixer like what I have here, and you add some sugar to it and a little bit of stabilizer, I'm using cream of tartar here for this, and you whip it, it makes this amazing meringue. And this is completely vegan.
That's amazing. And that's
Isn't that amazing?
And you use this throughout your entire cookbook. All of your recipes are using this aquafab.
Now, not all of the recipes in it use it in this way,
yeah.
In this whipped way, but when eggs are really good for two things, so they're good for binding and they're good for leavening. And this is leavening. So this makes things really fluffy and light. So cakes, muffins, waffles, makes things really fluffy and light. And it's really great for that. So in some of the recipes in my book, you use it just as is, mm-hmm. like a couple tablespoons thrown in as an egg substitute. And in some of them, you whip it and then fold it in at the end. And then that makes your baking like really lovely and light and fluffy.
Wonderful. And so we're calling this a chickpea food. So is that essentially what it is?
Yeah, I mean, it's made out of chickpea water, although you could really use any kind of bean water, really, technically speaking. Although you may want to stay away from the ones that are darker colored beans because they have kind of a weird color to them.
Okay.
They still work fine. They just kind of have a weird color. Like you might want to cover them up with like, say, for example, some chocolate.
Gotcha. Okay. So for this, in this case, you put your aquafaba in there, and you added a little bit of sugar.
That's right.
Okay. You whipped it up.
And some cream of tartar.
Okay.
It takes about 10 minutes for it to get to this really nice, fluffy, whipped up stage.
You were whipping this for a while before we started the segment.
I was before. Through the magic of television, I was whipping it already. And so now what we have is you just have this beautiful bowl of lovely, fluffy white mousse. And then all we're going to do to make this chocolate mousse is we're just going to add some melted dark chocolate. I'll just hand this over to you, actually.
Hold it in. Okay.
There you go. And we're just going to very carefully fold in some... Yeah, go for it. Go for it.
Really
I say more chocolate.
Yeah.
Right?
Sounds amazing.
It's
so light and fluffy.
I know. And you just... The mousse will... It'll fall a little bit as you fold it in. But it makes this really beautiful, lovely chocolate mousse.
That's great.
And this is completely 100% vegan.
Amazing. Okay, so I would fold that in, and it would end up looking a lot like this.
Yeah, so then what you'd need to do is to put it in the fridge and just let it set up in the fridge. I usually will let it set up in the fridge maybe for, you know, like overnight. And then it just looks like this. And then what I would do to finish this off is I might actually just steal a little bit of this. That we just, it's not quite finished. Hang on, can I grab a spoon?
Yeah. So maybe a little bit of a whipped cream.
Just a little bit of kind of like a whipped cream on top, on there. and then what I would do is take some nice leftover dark chocolate and just kind of grate that over there on top.
This looks delicious.
Oh, yeah.
So does aquafaba work best in sweet recipes or savory recipes?
You can do either way. It works well in savory recipes, but it also works great in sweet recipes. There's a whole section in the book as well for beans. So now that you've opened up all these cans of beans so that you can have the aquafaba out of them, what do you do with all the beans you have sitting around your house? There's definitely sweet recipes and savory recipes in there, but it really is this amazing miracle ingredient that is really changing the way vegans eat.
Fantastic. And if you have an egg allergy...
If you have an egg allergy, a lot of kids these days have egg allergies. It's something that they have to stay away from. Let's get in there.
Aquafabulous.
I know, it's really exciting.
I can't wait to try it. Chocolatey mousse. Wow, you never know this is chickpea.
It doesn't taste like chickpeas. Like, that's one of the things people ask me all the time. They're like, does it taste like beans? And it doesn't.
Not at all. That's amazing. Rebecca, thank you for coming in. Great ideas. If you want to watch this segment again, you can go to our website, ctvmorninglive.ca. Stay with us. We have The Last Word coming up next.